As more of you prepare to return to campus, I want to share a few bits of practical advice and provide some reassurance. First of all, it's great to be on campus today to record this message. I've been here quite a bit, as have those students and members of staff who have been allowed on campus because of the subjects they are studying or teaching. It's been very safe throughout, with, as far as we understand, no recorded cases of on-campus transmission of the virus.
My name is Dean Fraser. I work in our Student Journey department here in the Gateway Inquiries team at the university. We're thrilled to be back seeing students and staff on campus. We have opened up our inquiry desk both at our City campus and our Sir Tom Carey campus at St Peter's. We're seeing more students and staff come in every single day, and we're thrilled to see people enjoying the facilities that we do have on both campuses.
Now, of course, for all of us, this has been the most extraordinary time. It's odd, isn't it, to think how much has changed and how seemingly small things like shopping now seem like quite a big deal. As an example, at the university, being able to talk to staff in our cafe when I pick up a coffee, or join students on campus in a lecture or a laboratory. These are things that I would have just taken for granted over a year ago, but never again, as I have found a newfound appreciation of the preciousness of such moments when we are together.
Hey everyone, I'm George, you're the National Officer here at the University of Sunderland, and it's great to be back on campus. I have to say that I'm so grateful to be back on campus because I'm going to see people again. I have to say that the university took all the safety measurements. I feel so safe to be back. Just to remind everyone, you still need to wear your face mask when you're moving around the campuses, and you need to carry on your card because our buildings will be only card access. And now that we are back on campus, you can walk in either in the SU or here at the university, either when you need help or you have a question, just walk in and we will be more than happy to help you.
Now, I know for some that the return to normality cannot come soon enough. For others, though, the change might trigger feelings of uncertainty or even anxiety. All of that is to be expected. We have been through a great deal of change, and at times that can feel quite overwhelming. Let me assure you, though, that there are people to help you. And as I suggested earlier, we have all kinds of measures in place to keep you safe. Now, please continue to do your part too, just as you have been doing throughout the pandemic.
You know, they've got all the precautions in place, you know, masks, social distancing, all the washing. And the way, like, the practicals are set out, we're never near anybody for obviously like over 15 minutes. It's literally just passing by, so you can't fault anything. So I've been absolutely fine coming on campus. I really enjoy being actually able to get in. So yeah, I don't mind at all.
It is so much of a point that they make to make sure that our students are safe, that they have people regularly going around checking that everybody's wearing their masks, social distancing measures are upheld, and students themselves are actually doing a really good job in making sure that their person next to them is doing that as well.
Follow our safe campus guidance. There are signs all round to help you. Although I think we're all quite used now to the hands, face, space mantra. Frankly, that has served us well. And overall, we have seen comparatively low infection rates in our university community. To really make a difference now, we also need you to add testing to the list of things that you do. Regular testing, particularly when you do not have symptoms, will help to identify anyone who could, albeit unknowingly, infect others with COVID-19. Taking a test is actually quite simple, and there are now more ways to do it. Before you come onto campus for the first time, you need to arrange to have three tests at a testing centre. That could be the one that we have here on the city campus in Sunderland, or one close to where you live, whether that's in Sunderland itself or in London. Look at your local council website where you will find details. Once you've had your first three tests, you can test at home if you prefer. There are lots of ways to get hold of test kits, along with information on how and where to report your results. Look out for details on About US and in the weekly emails.
Hi, I'm Kayleigh. I work at St Mary's Childcare Centre, which is the nursery based at the university on city campus. We've been open since September, and I was really happy to come back. Before we came back, we had to put policies and procedures into place. We also carried out risk assessments just to ensure that it was safe for staff and children and also the parents. Also having the testing in place, staff at the nursery are doing that twice a week. And I think that gives everybody a little bit of peace of mind and reassurance. And that makes us all feel a lot more safer within our working environment as well.
For up-to-date information on your course and timetable, be sure to look at your programme pages on Canvas, which our programme leaders are updating regularly. Please, please stick to your face-to-face teaching timetable. This has been designed to meet your academic needs and ensure that there are never too many students in an area at once. Sticking to your timetable teaching, rather than popping in and out of other sessions, will mean that we can keep everyone safe and secure. Now that said, do make use of the facilities that are open to you, including our libraries, cafes, or City Space Fitness. You can also arrange to meet with the Students' Union, the Gateway, or the wellbeing teams to get any kind of support you need. Just remember your swipe card, as you will need this to open doors all around the campus. I will end by saying, as I always say, we are delighted that you have chosen to study with us. We are hugely impressed by the resilience you have shown over the last year and all that you have achieved, even in the face of such challenging circumstances. Now though, let's continue with the progress we've made, embrace the gradual reopening, and return to campus. Welcome back.